too good.
We won state last year.
Yeah. We're not liking it.
Yeah.
Been through this event, all right? I think it's half of the college starters in college, 28 at one point of 32 starters in the NFL. You go back to Tom Brady, Drew Brees, Matthew Stafford, Andrew Luck, Jameis Winston. Who else was in there that I had on my list? Marcus, all right, from right here. Shouldn't have forgot him, being from here as well. All wore the same jerseys you guys have on today. So understand you're a part of that fraternity now. So take advantage of that today. You're gonna get great coaching, all right? You're gonna get great competition, and you're gonna get great exposure.
Okay, just talk to me, don't worry about him.
All right, Dirk Knudsen with you, Vibe Sports Network here at Oregon. I'm here at the opening regional, and I got with me Osa Odigizua, did I say it right?
Yeah.
That's a famous last name around the Northwest because your big brother, Owa Magbi, he's gone on to play NFL football now, right?
Yeah.
How's he doing? Where's he at and how's he doing?
He's in New York right now. I think they're still doing like mini camps and stuff like that. He's doing pretty well. Heard he's giving the offensive guys a tough time.
He was quite a player coming out of David Douglas High School. You're at David Douglas now. Now, are you the third or fourth brother that's come through the high school?
Fourth.
And you're here today to play defensive line?
Yeah.
Okay, what's your height and weight coming in today, Osa?
Like 6'3", like 257.
Are you the biggest of the brothers?
When they're my age, yeah.
Yeah, your mom says you're her big boy, I think she says, on Facebook. You know, your mom gets on Facebook and talks about you?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, I love your mom. She's a great lady. Anything happening with you recruiting-wise yet?
I committed to UCLA for football.
When did you do that?
It was in March.
So that's why everybody's kind of got you off the radar a little bit. It's quiet right now.
Yeah.
How excited are you to go play at UCLA and follow in your brother's footsteps?
Super excited. Just want to go make a name for myself there, see what I can do.
Right on. Play the same position as your brother, you think?
I don't know. It depends on where my weight goes. Like, if I stay at 260, then, like, if I, like, stay in the 260 area, then I'm probably just going to stay a good D-end.
Mm-hmm.
But right now they got me playing both at high school, so
yeah.
If I gain weight, then I'll probably go D-tackle.
D-tackle.
And just stay inside.
Yeah, you got a year to go.
Yeah.
One more year, David Douglas. What do you think when people watch you play and you know, you analyze yourself a little bit, what's your best asset as a player? What's the top skill you have out there?
Just explosiveness and strength.
Got a high motor?
Yeah.
Find the football, destroy, that kind of thing?
Yeah.
It seems to run in your family genes that you guys are good athletes. How about the other boys? How are they doing?
My brother Iggy's good. He's not playing football anymore.
Right.
EO, he just signed with Oregon State, so he's going to be wrestling there.
He's the big-time wrestler.
Yeah.
Yeah, had a chance to see him in high school. Well, your family and you boys have made quite a name for yourselves out in the East County at David Douglas. Good luck this year. Congratulations on the UCLA commitment. It's big time, and go get them today. Represent the Northwest out here at the Nike opening camp, all right?
Yeah.
All right, Elsa, thanks for your time.
No problem.
All right, good. All right, Dirk back with you, Vibe Sports Network, here at the Nike Open Regional at University of Oregon. Got with me Anjay Hughes-Murray.
Got it right?
Yes, sir.
Anjay, you just came from the Combine. You've also been at Oregon State and making the rounds. How's the summer just got going? School just got out. How's things going?
Things are going real well. I've been hearing from schools left and right now. I heard a little bit from Oregon State. They said they really liked me when I went down to their camp. I was just at a little unofficial at Portland State yesterday.
And who do you have offers from right now?
UNLV, Air Force, Montana, Eastern Washington. Those are just some of the few.
Yeah.
Those are just some of the few.
No Pac-12 offer yet?
No, close. Unfortunately not. I know a few are close, but, you know, hopefully I'll see it.
And your height and weight is, you're about 6'2", 230?
Actually 6'3", 240.
Okay.
6'3", 240.
I know he's right in there, man. You're one of the bigger linebackers around. You're known for your explosiveness and playmaking. What are some things you've done this year in the offseason to improve?
Definitely just working on agility, change direction, all that stuff. It's really helped in 7-on-7. Yeah, that's one that I've been doing a lot.
Good.
Especially in this offseason.
Yeah, but seeing you get out and about. All right, well, good luck today. We'll let you get ready for camp.
Yes, sir.
On Jay.
Yep.
Hughes Murray. Thank you. Federal Way High School in the house. Good luck today.
Yes, sir.
All right. You want me to go? All right, Dirk Knutson back with you. Vibe Sports, Northwest Prep Report. Got with me Cody Knaus, right?
Yes, sir.
Cody, tell us your height, weight, year in school, and where do you play?
Cody Knaus, 6'7", 295, offensive tackle at Peninsula High School.
295, you're down a little bit. You getting to that playing weight?
Trying my best. You know, I started out a few weeks ago 317 and then just getting it down for the season, so I'm excited.
You look good. I had a chance to see some film you've been putting up on Facebook. You've been making the rounds with, I think, your dad doing some traveling. You had a chance to come to Oregon and do it unofficial here. How'd that go for you?
It was great. You know, hospitality was wonderful. You know, treated me like family. And Coach Greatwood's a great guy. And all the players, you know, came up, always giving me a handshake. And it was a really great experience. I'm glad to be here.
You just finished your 10th grade year. You got two seasons left. You're one of about three or four now. What we feel are really big-time recruits coming out of the state of Washington for 2017. How do you feel about, you know, being in a class of guys like Foster Sorrell, and we've talked about Henry Bayanabalo, who's going to be here. All these guys starting getting offers. You got to be real close. Does it feel good to have a group of that talent level coming out?
Absolutely. You know, I played baseball with Fozzie and Henry, great guy, great family. So it's really a good thing to be around good people. And I love, you know, being around good guys. So it's great.
Must have been something in the water that year, because those guys are all about your size, and you're one of the biggest athletes out here. What are you hearing from coaches about what they want to see from you, like collegiate coaches? Are they coaching you up on some things you need to work on?
Absolutely. It's just using my length to my advantage, you know, pushing and not hopping in my stances. You know, just staying low and being flexible is what is that lateral movement.
Yeah.
So working on it, you know, doing yoga, doing workouts with my dad. And so it's, you know, it's doing really good. I got a lot of help and it's wonderful.
Well, you're right on track for being a big time recruit, which we feel you are and you hope you are. And the offers are going to come. So have a great day today. You got a lot of big talent in the house, and good luck stopping those defensive linemen.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Okay. Cody, you ready? Okay. Dirk Knutson back with you, Northwest Prep Report. Got with me Connor Mitchell. Connor, Oregon City High School, right?
Yes, sir.
What's your height and weight coming into camp today?
I'm 5'8", 185.
And you're going into your third or fourth year as a varsity player?
Fourth year.
Oregon City's looking good again this year. How's things going for you recruiting-wise? I know you had some interest, offers, that kind of thing. What's happening?
I've been talking to Arizona State a lot. They've been in contact with me in Wyoming. I'm talking to PSU. PSU is probably the one who's might offer me. If anybody offers me soon, it would be them.
How's things going with PSU? Have you talked to them about the new coaching staff and all that?
I haven't really been in contact that much with them, but I just talked to Ben the other day at the OSU camp, and I'm going down to their camp on the 24th. So,
what are you competing at today?
I'm playing wide receiver today.
Good spot for you?
Yeah, wide receiver slot, wherever I
You like that slot?
Just get the ball in my hands.
You basically have cranked out a highlight reel every year you've played with the style of play you have with your speed and agility. What I've been asking guys is, what's your top skill coming into camp today? What's your top thing that you think you're best known for?
Probably just my speed and my hands, honestly. I can get off the ball pretty good, and I can get up and jump the ball. Even though I'm short, I'll get up and get the ball.
Yes, you can. All right, Connor Mitchell, good luck out there today. Thanks for taking the time to talk to us.
Thank you. All right, it's good seeing you.
We good? Just give me a second, okay? All right, walking in the facility now here at the Nike Opening Regional is Henry Bayanabalo from Skyline High School, 2017?
Yeah, 2017.
Henry, we've seen each other three or four times in a row, and you're part of that triumvirate of guys coming out of the state of Washington for 2017. Tell us about the last couple offers and how things are going.
Recently, I've been offered by Nebraska and USC, and they're big offers for me just to know that Nebraska and USC schools like that want me, and it's just a big honor.
When we first met three or four months ago, at the longest, you were just getting started, had the one offer. Now it's kind of really taken off, hasn't it? How's that affected everything? Is it hard to kind of keep grounded, or are you doing okay?
I think I'm staying grounded. You know, it's still sort of hard to wrap my head around it that I've got all these offers, but it's just a nice feeling.
It's got to be a nice feeling because everybody here is fighting for those spots. So what's next for you, Henry? And obviously today you're coming here to make a statement here in front of Nike and maybe get a shot to go to the opening. What's next for you after this?
After this, it's just training with my team, maybe take a couple of visits to schools and unofficial visits and see how those schools look for me and if I really blend well with those. So that's pretty much what I have planned for this summer.
Thank you, Henry. Thanks for your time. Good to see you once again. Congratulations, USC, Nebraska. Those are big time, along with Michigan, Oregon. Oregon right here has offered you. You got a lot of decisions to make in the near future, don't you?
Oh, yes, I do.
Henry Bonavallo, good student, great athlete. Thanks for taking the time. And we're good. All right, Dirk Knutson, Vibe Sports, Northwest Prep Report, back in the house with outstanding underclassmen offensive lineman coming up out of Lake Oswego. Is that right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right.
Tell us your name, height, weight.
My name is Dawson Jaramillo. I'm 6'5", 265.
How do you spell your last name, Dawson?
Jaramillo.
So I said Jaramillo before, but it's
Jaramillo.
Jaramillo.
Yep.
Okay. So as far as football goes, your name's been getting out partly because of your size as a freshman. Well, you're going to be a sophomore now, I guess, because your freshman year's over.
Yeah.
How is things going recruiting-wise? Because you have generated a lot of attention. Is anything happening beyond talk, or kind of what's happening with you?
Well, I've talked to Oregon a little bit, Oregon State. Kind of know some people down there. My some family played down there, but that's pretty much it. Okay. Talking to colleges and things like that.
You're too young for anybody to do too much with anyway, other than show interest in. And what part of your game are you looking to enhance the most this offseason?
Well, I'm young, so a lot, everything pretty much working on. I'm definitely not the level that I need to be at to play at the next level, so just working on everything. Get in the weight room a lot.
Yeah.
Just being out in the field and getting better every day.
Right on. You've got three seasons to go. Play for one of my favorite coaches, probably one of the best mentors a guy could have, and Coach Steve Corey and the whole staff at Lake Oswego. How are things looking out at Lake O this year?
I think it's looking well. Our line majority is going to be seniors, senior quarterback, senior running back. Our receivers are good. I think we're going to do well this year.
All right. Thank you for taking the time to talk to us.
No problem.
Looking forward to seeing a lot more of you from the years to come.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. Thanks very much.
Yeah.
Bless you. All right. Dirk Knutson back with you, Vibe Sports. I got with me one of the biggest recruits and in a couple of ways, both physically and in terms of what's happening recruiting-wise, Jared Goldwire, 2016, from Kentwood.
Right? Yes, sir.
I didn't want to say it wrong because you have moved around a little bit. You are at Kentwood right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Jared, landed your first offer from Hawaii recently. What else is happening since I saw you last?
Just went on a recruiting visit. Just went to Portland State, saw Portland State. Went to the Oregon State camp also. Did good there, and then now I'm here at the Oregon.
What did Oregon State have to say to you? You went in as a defensive lineman?
No, I'll be an O-lineman there, most likely.
You're finally starting to hear it from the college coaches like a bunch of us have been bugging you, because we love you as a D-lineman, but we see offense in your future. You don't really care, do you?
Honestly, no, not at this point. But here at the opening, I'll be doing defensive line.
Defensive line?
Yes, sir.
All right, Jared. And your height and weight is what right now?
I'm 6'5 and a half, 294 pounds.
You're only 6'5 and a half?
Yeah, that's what, you know, they measure me as, you know, but I believe I'm around like 6'6", 6'7".
Okay. I always thought you were at least 6'6", going to 6'7". Anyway, who cares? You got to play, right? Jared Goldwater, good luck today. One of the top talents coming out of the Pacific Northwest this year. Always good to see you.
Thank you, sir.
All right. All right, Dirk Knutson back with you, Northwest Prep Report, part of the Vibe Sports Network. And I got with me Elijah Molden, one of our top standout players for Oregon, class of 2017. Do I got that right?
Yes, you do. Perfect.
You showed up when you were a freshman, so it's hard to stay in touch with you guys that are so young. I always forget. Seems like you're about ready to graduate. You got two seasons left. Talk to us about the offers that you do have and where that sits right now.
I got Oregon, Stanford, Washington, and Washington State. And all of them, I think I worked hard and earned them, and hopefully I can reel in some more.
You're playing defensive back, right? You play both ways in high school. We both talked. We think probably defense is where you go in college?
Yeah, right. And I've talked to some of the coaches, and they may say special teams or maybe a little bit of offense, but I think cornerback is for sure the position.
So you got Oregon. Your dad, Alex Molden, played here.
Right.
He played in the NFL, right? So for most kids, that would be it. Like, I just want to go where my dad went and fill his shoes, or try to fill his shoes, or be better than him, or however you want to look at it. But with you, it sounds like you really want to take your time. There's some other schools that you're hearing from that you wouldn't mind getting an offer from. Who are some of those guys?
I wouldn't mind Michigan, or if I got more in contact with Florida State, that'd be nice. Notre Dame, UCLA, those schools.
Okay. all quality programs. Mm-hmm. You got a bunch of great programs in hand. So how do you approach the next 2 years to kind of just balance everything? I mean, as a person and as a recruit, what are some things that, what are your philosophies kind of going forward?
Right, I gotta stay humble, first of all, because anything can happen at any time. I mean, my injury, you know, with my face, that came out of nowhere, and it was really humbling. So I gotta stay humble and just let things come to me and make the best decision for me and my family.
So let's talk about that for a minute. You got injured at a 7-on-7 event up in Vegas, one of the bigger ones. It was just one of those things. Kind of got hit in the eye area by a teammate.
Brady, yeah.
And Brady Breeze, top recruit for Oregon, who is committed to Oregon, and he had a brace of some kind on. Just one of those things that happens. Has it changed your opinion about how you can approach 7-on-7 at all?
Not really. I don't think about it when I'm out there. It is, you know, it is pretty dangerous without a helmet. Actually, I had a helmet on.
You had one of the
Right. So it's just one of those things that you can't control and hope for the best.
So you're a top recruit with offers, so it's kind of like having money in the bank as long as you take care of your grades and your health. Does it make you maybe think about not doing as much events like a 7-on event?
I always want to show people what I can do, so you know, those events...
You're a gamer, so
Those events are showcases for me, because I know what I can do, I just want to prove it.
Okay. Well, I appreciate you talking to us about that. I know with recruits it's always tough when you sustain an injury, and that one was pretty severe, but you came back from it, everything's 100%?
Yeah, everything's good.
God bless.
I start contacting a little bit, but I'm all healed up.
God bless. Well, tear them up out there today. Thank Boys you. In the house from Northwest got to represent some awfully good talent coming in. And so, Elijah Molden, thank you for the time.
Thank you very much. Pretty.
Okay, Dirk Knudsen back with you, NorthwestPrepReport.com. Got with me Tigard High's Connor Crisk, one of the very top linemen in the state of Oregon. Connor, how's it going?
It's going well.
And today here at the opening, you're going offense. What's your height and weight coming into camp?
6'3", like 310.
And we just saw you recently at Northwest Elite Camp. Those one-on-ones were a little frustrating just because of the format. Today we're going to have a full set of linemen, and you're going to go in as a center guard?
Yep, working inside. It's probably what I'll play in college, so got to get some work there.
It'll probably go a little bit easier or better today when you don't have guys running wide way outside you, because you really don't face that, right? You got a real small box you have to operate in out there on the high school field, don't you?
Yeah, you don't really see a lot of wide nines outside rushers. But
from defensive tackles?
Yeah. But you got to get used to it. So,
what do you need to do here today, do you think, to kind of put a stamp on your recruiting and your skill?
I think that I'm going to shoot for the O-line MVP. I think if I'm in the consideration for that, I'm going to do that'll boost my recruiting a little bit.
And recruiting-wise, you got an offer from one of the Ivies. Tell us who that was.
Yale.
Beautiful. And who else is getting close with you, do you think?
Portland State, I think, and then Boise State, and then maybe Oregon, depending on how I do on Wednesday.
Well, we hope you the best out there today. A lot of out-of-state talent. Go get them, will you?
All right, yeah.
All right, Connor Crisk, Tigard High School. Thanks for the time.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. Got him, okay?
Yeah.
You ready? All right, another top camper here with me today from Mighty Bellevue High School.
Yes,
got that
sir.
Right? Got Omar Dials with me. Omar, you're a 2016 guy, right?
Yes, sir.
And tell us your height and weight.
6'1", 285.
Coming into camp today to play defense again?
Yes, sir.
You were an MVP standout in under the Northwest Prep Reports book. And really had quite a showing at the Northwest Elite Football Camp. What are you looking to do today that maybe didn't happen last time?
Today I'm looking forward to getting to compete against some of these guys out here. There's a lot of good talent from all across the country, and I'm just trying to set the tone, and yeah, that's all I want to do.
You're not the biggest guy, but you're violent with your hands, you're great with your feet. So how is this a showcase with all these big, there's some bigs here, a lot of 6'6", 6'7", 6'8". Good opportunity in front of a big stage to really show what you can do with your frame.
Yeah, there's a lot of big guys, like you said, and you know I'm kind of undersized, but I try to use my height and my weight to get under those big guys and do what I can and use my force.
Talk to me about recruiting. What's happening?
I got offers from Montana State, and UC Davis. I'm hearing from UW, Wazoo, Portland State, Oregon State, UCLA, Wyoming, and UNLV.
Omar Dials, outstanding. I'm looking forward to watching you because it's always fun to watch a guy with your motor, your power, and technique against these bigger boys. Good luck out there today.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
All right. We on? All right. Dirk Knudsen, Vibe Sports Network, Northwest Prep Report, back with Tiano Tialavea. I got it right?
Yep. Yes, sir.
MVP two weekends ago at the Northwest Elite Football Camp. Different group of guys, some of the same guys, but some big-time O-linemen here in a more controlled environment probably.
Yep.
Today in the one-on-ones, you're going in as a defensive tackle?
Yes, I am.
And your height and weight is what?
6'4", 345 pounds.
And we talked a little bit with all that force and power you can generate, you still want to come down, you want to get your weight down a little bit. What's your plan, what you're shooting for when the season starts?
Probably about 315, probably. A lot of conditioning right now, so.
Yeah, you look better every time I see you, man. So keep that going. We all work on that. And so today at Oregon, what are you expecting to accomplish and what are you hoping for?
Well, I see a lot of people from American Samoa from my bloodline, so hopefully I'm trying to see some more competition from out there and all over the country.
I actually saw three players on the recruiting sheet from AS, and it's American Samoa, so we have some guys coming directly from the island.
Yes, we do. I saw a couple guys better from the O-line, so it was some good competition.
That must be kind of cool to see guys actually coming from the homeland. You weren't born there, were you?
No, I was not. My dad was, though. So well, I have a lot of family out there, too.
Samoan blood, family runs strong, doesn't it?
It does. It really does. Family-oriented.
What drives that? Because, you know, I've known that for years, just knowing people from Polynesia. They're all very family-oriented. But what's with the Samoan side of it and the family being so strong? Where does that come from?
I don't know. It's just like from back in the day, all of our family have always been together. And, like, other families and all Samoans are very opening. And, like, bring other people in. We're all family. So I don't know where it drives from.
Samoans are kind of known for the toughness and all of that, but when you get past all that, really loving people, aren't they?
Yeah, we are.
Love food?
We love food.
Music?
Music, yep. Reggae music.
So, women, all the good stuff?
Everything.
No disrespect to anybody else, but yeah, it's the good stuff. And we can't wait to see some of that good stuff come out in the field today, Tiano. Good luck, and represent the Northwest, will you?
Yeah, will do. Thank you very much.
Been bothering us at all? Okay. All right, Dirk Knudsen, NorthwestPrepReport.com. Got with me Evan Weaver from Gonzaga Prep. Evan, how's it going?
Pretty good. How are you?
Very good. Outstanding camp you had at Northwest Elite. It was great to see you got an MVP there at the D-line position. You're coming D-line today?
Yeah, we'll be playing D-line. Yep, DN.
Those of us in the Northwest know about you, but for people who don't maybe know as much because you're from Eastern Washington out there in great Spokane Valley, what's happening with you with offers and such?
Well, I have 12 right now, and just a bunch of Pac-12 schools, a bunch of Power 5 conferences schools are starting to send a lot of mail and have a lot of interest, so just kind of keeping everything open, just seeing how it goes.
What's your height and weight coming into camp?
I'm 6'3", 240.
Okay. What are the colleges seeing in you? What is it they like best about your game?
They love my motor and my flexibility to play anywhere on the field. Most schools are not sure where I'm playing yet, so like linebacker, DN.
Really?
I've been playing some D-tackle, so just because of my speed and my agility, I guess. So.
How'd the combine go today? Did you participate?
Yeah, I ran a 4.75 40 and got the longest power ball with a 44.
44?
Yeah.
Wow, that's outstanding. What was your spark score overall?
They haven't given them yet, so.
Well, no doubt, Evan, I knew those scores would be good. Anybody tossing the Powerball 44 has got something going on. You do. Good luck out there today. What are you going as, D-line?
Defensive end.
Okay. Good luck today, Evan Weaver.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, Dirk Knudsen back with you. Tell us your name, height, weight, and what school you go to.
Esau Longoria. I'm 6'3", 270 pounds, and I go to Valley View High School in Caldwell, Idaho.
Caldwell, Idaho. That's a ways away from here.
Oh, yeah. It's about 8 hours, 8.5 hours.
So what's it like being out here at University of Oregon, home of the Mighty Ducks?
It's unreal. I mean, I've been going to Boise State games since I was about 6 years old, and then see a facility like this is pretty unreal.
And you're coming in as a defensive lineman?
Yes, I am.
Okay. And what's your height and weight today? I might have asked you, but what is it?
I'm at 6'3 right now, 270.
Okay. What are you hoping to get out of today? What are some things that can come out of this that'll help you?
Getting an invite to the final to be unreal, but I want to get back some stuff, bring back to my high school, and hopefully lead us to state championship this year.
Very good. And what's happening with recruiting with you?
Right now I have two offers for football, two offers for baseball, and I'm talking with some other schools, so hopefully get some.
Wow. Who's got you for football?
Right now, football, I have a full ride from College of Idaho and a full ride from Idaho State.
The in-state schools like you. They want to keep you home.
Yeah, they're going to try to.
Hey, good luck to them, and good luck to you today. We'll look forward to seeing you.
All right, thank you. Take care.
Over the last day.
Right there. 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 Right
Okay. You ready?
Okay, Dirk Knitsch and Vibe Sports, NorthwestPrepReport.com. Got with me Sam Neuer from Beaverton High School. Sam, how's it going?
It's going really well. You had a good day out here and just looking to get better now.
You had the Colorado offer a month or so ago. Mm-hmm. You made the trip up there to visit Boulder, right?
Yep.
Loved it. So tell us what happened up there.
So, you know, I got there, and from the time I got there, even before, you know, they were really talking good about me, you know, telling me good things and stuff. So when I went up there, you know, they had everything planned out. We went and took a tour of the facilities, took a tour of the campus. And, I mean, Boulder's a beautiful city, and I really enjoyed it, enjoyed the coaching staff a lot. And, you know, I think that they're definitely on the come up, and I'm excited to be a part of it.
Were there some other recruits in camp in visitation when you came up?
Not at the time. It was just me. So that was nice, just because it was a personal thing, one on one. So you know, I appreciated that. And but now it's time to just get some more recruits up there and get to work.
That's what I was going to ask you. Colorado's recruited in Oregon for a long time. I mean, going way back to the Brock brothers and people like that. Who came out of Beaverton, Jesuit, places like that, have gone up there to play. But do they plan to be more active in the Northwest? Have they got you kind of keeping your eyes open?
Yeah, you know, they definitely do, but it's mainly me. You know, I see who they offer, I go, and I reach out to them and try to build a relationship between us. And, you know, they really can't tell me to talk to people, but you know how that works. But, you know, I definitely reach out to them and try to build a relationship for sure.
What kind of offense do they plan to run? Is it something that fits right with your skill set?
Exactly the same thing. Spread offense. You know, it's the same exact thing that we run, which was made it a lot easier on me. Just it's going to be such a smooth transition. And Coach Lindgren is a great guy, and they're OC, and I'm really excited to work with them.
In front of you, they have from Bellarmine Prep up in Washington, Cepho Leofau, who's really well thought of there. He's playing. You didn't have a chance to meet with him, but have you analyzed kind of the depth chart at their QB positions?
Yeah, you know, obviously I'm going to go in and compete for the job. You know, it's going to be tough with Cepho and stuff, but, you know, I'm going to go and compete and then see what happens from there. But it's going to be nice to learn from him because he definitely has a lot of experience and he's a great player.
Yeah, sure. So let's talk about Beaverton for a minute. You guys were super competitive last year. I know year in and year out, it seems like there's plenty of talent at Beaverton. Maybe the numbers aren't quite what they are at some of the other schools. But talk to me a little bit about the team this year. How are things looking for you and the Beavers going into your senior year?
You know, we had a great spring so far. You know, we just finished spring ball and looked really well. You know, we went out to Canby and competed and did really well. And, you know, I'm really excited about this year. I truly am. And last year wasn't the year we wanted to have. We didn't finish the way we wanted. But we're definitely going to build off that and go win some more games this year.
Who are a couple guys that will be helping to lead the team forward this year along with yourself?
You know, it's there's a lot of guys. I mean, I can name my whole team. But Anthony Albright, running back, he was out here today, ran a 4.4.
Wow.
Carson Crawford, he's gonna play slot for us next year. He's gonna be really good. Matayo Talemotu, good receiver. You know, we got guys on our defense. We're gonna be pretty tough this year. And our offensive line is gonna be pretty good, which we haven't had in a while. Yeah.
Sam Neuer, it's great to talk with you. I'm glad you got your recruitment done. It's going to let you relax the rest of the summer. It's only June. Mm-hmm. You think you'll actually do anything besides football this summer?
You know, maybe throw the baseball a few times, but, you know, maybe shoot some hoops. But other than that, I mean, might go take a few trips, but other than that, it's just football grind.
You got a girlfriend?
Do got a girlfriend.
Is she cute?
She's really cute.
Is it serious?
It's pretty serious. Dating for 2 years now, so yeah.
All right, well, more on that as the season unfolds, and hopefully that relationship will last as long as yours with football does, which could be a long time.
Yes,
Sam Neuer, you come from a great sports family, a great program at Beaverton, and good luck with everything going forward from here.
Thank you, I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Sam Neuer, Beaverton High School.